So the first thing we need to ask ourselves is, what is area? And easiest way to do that is, it's the two-dimensional space something takes up. All right, so we're looking at for how much two-dimensional space. So we're going to measure it in squares. So if we look at kind of these pictures over here, what is the area of this yellow rectangle? Well, how many squares are inside there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. All right, so this is 18 square something or another, square units. All right, so you're looking at me going, there's a much easier way to do that. Absolutely. We can find that area by just multiplying, right? 3 this way, 6 that way, so 3 times 6 is going to give us 18. Now, what about the triangle over here? We look at the triangle and we can count the squares inside of that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then if we kind of match up these extra ones, 7 and 8. So we think here the answer is 8. We could also use the formula, right? Half base times height, which is just thinking of this as a whole big square and then taking half of it, right? But the counting thing isn't going to work so well when we go to look at the circle, because it takes up parts, right, of squares. Like right here, how much of the square is that? Or over here, a little tiny bit. So we could get a good estimate. You know, we could count them. You know, 1, 2, count how many are inside here. There's 16 in this big one. Plus, I don't know, maybe about 2 more on each of these sides. So 16 plus 8, we're going to guess it's like 24. To find the exact area, you could use the formula, pi r squared, which in this case would be pi, the radius, which is 3 squared, or 9 times 3.14. So our guess wasn't that bad. Okay, so how, though, do you come up with this formula, pi r squared, or how do you find the area of a shape that's not one that you have a formula for? We're going to develop a method today that's going to let us do that.